Hello. You are on the channel Court of CG Computer Graphics. We continue to create a stylized character. In this video you will learn how to transfer textures from Substance Painter to Cinema 4D Physical Render. Please subscribe to the channel. I will open Substance Painter and export the textures. Since we created the project itself in metal roughness, we will do the export in the same preset. Choose a location to save the textures. Here we select a preset metal roughness. We choose the format. This is the resolution of the texture. For me it will be 2048. We select padding with diffusion. Click on export textures. Let's move on to Cinema 4D R26. In the scene, I pre-created the area lighting. Added HDR map. Added subdivision surface to character model. You can see my previous Cinema 4D tutorials. I explain everything there. I will create a new PBR material. Rename. Immediately add to the character model. I will open the material. I'll tick the color. I'll add a base color map here. Let's move on to reflection. On the diffusion tab in the color layer, we will also add a base color map. Click reflection default. I will change here to GGX. Now let's add a roughness map to the roughness. Add a metallic map to the reflection. Add a normal map to the normal tab. Enable displacement and add a height map here. I will decrease the intensity of the map by 0.1. Also in normal you need to check flip Y. Now you need to add subsurface scattering. Turn on luminance. I will create a layer. In this layer we will add a base color map. We will also add the subsurface scattering itself. For the skin, make the scattering red. I will decrease the path length. I'll turn on the render and see what it looks like. I will create a new PBR material, and this will be the eye texture. The principle of operation is the same. Put a check mark on the color. I am adding base color. Adding maps to reflection. We also add a base color in the color layer. Change the type to GGX in roughness and add roughness and a metallic map to the reflection. Adding a normal. Don't forget to check the box. Displacement, add height map and decrease intensity. We do the same with clothing items. I forgot to mention that you need to change the Fresnel tab setting of the layer. Here we simply indicate whether the material is a conductor or not. Here you can choose suitable presets. Let's continue. Thank you. Let's move on to the render settings. Physical rendering enabled. Added global illumination and ambient occlusion effects. Ambient occlusion made gray. For global illumination, you can pick up presets. I have a standard one. Sample quality is set to medium. Let's make a render. Thank you for watching. Like and subscribe to the channel. Goodbye.